Very good morning to all the students of class plus 1B. Fine, already I gave you instructions about your vaccination, about other participation. So please do it accordingly as per the messages sent to you in WhatsApp group. Okay, so let's start the new chapter, and this is the last chapter of your, you can say, syllabus, I guess. Everything we have covered so far. If anything will be left, I will see to it and will inform you. Fine, so this is the chapter Silk Road. Clear? And this book, Hornbill. Fine. So please open this book, Hornbill. Make sure you have your own book with you, so that in case of there are some difficult words in this chapter, a lot of difficult words, so you need to note down side by side. I'll make you write the meanings also. So let me introduce the characters in this chapter, Silk Road, first. Then we'll discuss the theme as we usually do, and then we'll start reading. Nick Middleton, he's the narrator of this story. Fine. You can see on the chapter number 8, on page number 74, it is written Nick Middleton. So he himself is present in this chapter, as he's going to have one traveling experience. Fine. So Nick Middleton is the narrator. Then we have Lamo, or sometimes when, you know, two consonants come together, L or H. So when we drop the sound, first letter drop the sound, so we can get Hamo also. Some people call it Hamo and Lamo, both you can consider. So Lamo, the girl who gifted him sheepskin coat. So he is on his way to journey. Actually, Nick Middleton is the author. He travels to Mount Kailash, exploring Himalayan belt in Tibet. Fine. So he is going to explore very, you can say, rough, you can say, path. Those who have done trekking and all, those who have gone to such places, some religious places also. Sometimes you go to Himalaya during breaks and all, then you might be knowing the dangers it includes. So exploration of the author to Mount Kailash, and how he explores the on the way, how he faces so many difficulties of language, and people do not understand his language. He's not able to understand their language. Even then he's surviving. And then due to the, you can say, what else we face when, you tell me, when we go to some new place, what are the differences over there? Every year we plan a trip and all. And sometimes we go to some states. First difficulty I told you about the language. Sometimes they do not understand what we speak. What can be the second difficulty? Yes, Aditi, you tell us, what can be the other difficulty? Very simple question I have asked. When we travel somewhere, what sort of difficulties we might face on our way? Yes, Aditi, I'm asking you. You need not search the answer of this thing anywhere else. Environmental changes. Anjali says environmental changes. Yes, that is there. Yes, Aditi. Travel sickness. Okay, Ramanjit is saying, yes, Diljit, very good. Diljit says food. She loves to eat, that's why Diljit will say like that only. So different, okay, very good. Food and environmental changes and weather, and you feel sickness, fine. So a lot of changes are there when we go to new place and new people we meet. Sometimes the language is different. So yes, these are the difficulties we face when we go to new place. Very good. So challenges and hardships faced in the Silk Road regions. Now you might be thinking, what is a Silk Road? Why this chapter is named Silk Road? That I'll tell you. So challenges faced by narrator, that is, or author Nick Middleton. So Nick Middleton has done, he has reached, he wanted to go there to Mount Kailash. And how he reached there, whether he'll be able to reach there or not, what he had gone through and all that, we will be reading in this chapter, Silk Road. Now, let me tell you why the chapter is named Silk Road. There was a time in ancient times, in the history, there was trade between India and China of silk. Fine. So silk was that, you can say, as a commodity, you can say, that business purpose. That import export, you know already about this. So that route was there when there was some business, you can say, between China and India. And that route was known as a Silk Route, through which that, you can say, connection was formed. So that route from where they would extract silk from China. So that route was known as a Silk Route. So now that's why they have named the chapter Silk Road. And author will be exploring that ancient historical route, fine, in this chapter. And he will be reaching Mount Kailash to complete his Kora. Now, this is the new word which you have to learn. Kora. What is Kora? This is your religious journey, fine. So sometimes you travel for the sake of, you can say, having adventurous experiences, going through the adventurous sports, and number of reasons are there. Sometimes you would like to relish the weather or snowfall or something like that, and picturesque beauty you want to relish, and you want a piece of mind. Different reasons are there. And some people are very religious, fine. And you know that every year, a lot of news is there that people were going to Amarnath, and many dangerous, you can say, incidents have happened in the past. And there is threat of terrorists also, and then there is threat of environmental factors are also there. People, lack of oxygen is there. The you know that we, like, the more you can say upside we move, less oxygen we have. So people who are fit physically, who are fit mentally, who are stable emotionally, are able to complete their journeys in a nice way as compared to the ones who are physically weaker. There are chances that you may fall sick also over there. So it is very difficult to complete that journey. So he's going to complete that religious journey is Kora, because he's going to Mount Kailash, right? So he's going to explore Himalayan mountain Tibet. Now, characters, Nick Middleton, protagonist and narrator. Then Lamo is the girl who gifted him sheepskin coat. So he stayed at a place named Rabu for a short span of time. And there he met a local girl, and she thought that you do not have, she was able to perceive that Nick Middleton is not having enough warm clothes. You know, the warm clothes we are wearing here, and the clothes which we wear in that minus degree temperatures, they are very different. They have to wear animal skinned clothes only, because they are too warm. So sheep-skinned, you can say, you know that many animals are used for making the clothing also, so to keep themselves warm and in the minus degree temperature. So she gifted him a sheepskin long sleeves coat so that he can cover himself properly for his further journey. So that was the girl, local girl. Fine. Then Satan. T aapka silent hai isme, but T is there in the spelling. Okay. So Satan is a local Tibetan who would ferry visitors to, just a tourist guide, okay, in short term, tourist guide as Satan. Fine. And he would take people to various places of Tibet, showing them, telling them the importance and historical importance in that way. Daniel is a translator who Nick Middleton hired because he knows Tibetan language, and he will be translating language of Nick to the Tibetan people and their language to Nick. So this, he's the translator. Then Norbu will be coming at last, or after the half of the chapter is done. So he will become friends with the, I was writing when I started speaking, right? So he became friends with narrator, right? So he is the one who will be the friend of narrator, because he, you know, and during this journey, you cannot say that, you know, I will be all alone. I will be doing this journey and expedition. Expeditions are so adventurous expeditions, and such routes, snow-covered, snow-clad mountains, they're very difficult to reach there. Many difficulties you can face. You have to pack your medicines and clothing and torch and a lot of extra clothing to keep yourself hydrated. A lot of liquids and so many things are required. And most above the all, you have to have a company also, so that in need you can be, you know, you can get help. So that he will be feeling secluded in between the journeys, and then he meets Norbu over there. Though their language was not same, but they will be sharing very common interests, and he will become friends with Norbu. Okay, so how they reaches there, how they reach there at Mount Kailash or not, that I will tell you. Okay. Is it clear to you all? Please send me thumbs up for that. Jaldi se. Introduction part is clear to you. Okay, fine. Let me share the screen. ठीक है बेटा. Yes, is it visible? Sometimes you know it is visible to us, not to you. So that's why I confirm. Screen सबको visible है? Yes, बेटा. चलिए लेट्स स्टार्ट. सो देयर आर सम वर्ड्स बेटा रिटन. प्लीज क्विकली राइट डाउन द मीनिंग्स ऑफ दीज वर्ड्स. दीज वर्ड्स यू कैन सी हाइलाइटेड ऑलरेडी. दे हैव हाइलाइटेड दीज वर्ड्स इनटू द बुक विद डार्क ब्लैक कलर. सो यू राइट डाउन द मीनिंग ओवर हेयर ओनली सो दैट इट विल बी इजियर फॉर यू. सॉरी, डकिंग बैक, क्विकली गोइंग इनसाइड and come back, ducking back. When that girl went inside her room and quickly comes back with a long sleeve coat, so then they have used this term, ducking back into her tent. Ducking back is quickly going inside and come back. Swath, this word means, swath means long strip of land covered with snow. Swath ek jaise when you do the shave करते हैं तो भी swath बन जाता है ना ऊपर. So swath of snow, swath here is used for covered snow on the, you can say land, you can say careered down. Third word is careered down is descending slope. Please write down the meaning of this. Descending slope. Then maneuvers. Maneuvers are here in this. Maneuvers are drilled practices, or you can say exercises. You know, military exercises, particularly. You write down accordingly. Military exercises, maneuvers, military exercises. जैसे वो drill करते हैं. On 26th, might have seen how they do practice and exercises all together in same movement. Then next word is cairn of rocks. Cairn of rocks is pile of stones. एक ढेर है पत्थरों का, in that way. Salt flats. Salt flats doesn't mean salt. Salt flats here means snow covered roofs of houses. Right? Flats. Snow covered houses. Salt flats. उनको बोला कि सब घर बर्फ से ढके होते हैं वहां पे. Last word is billowed. Filled with the air and swelled out. Filled with the air and swelled out. Clear? Everybody has noted down the word meanings. Now let's start the reading. A flawless half moon floated in a perfect blue sky on the morning we said our goodbyes. Extended banks of cloud. Extended banks of cloud like long French loaves glowed pink as the sun emerged to splash the distant mountain tops with a rose tinted blush. So this, they are just explaining it, that how clouds could be seen and pinkish color was glowing and sun was emerging, like was giving a kind of rose tinted blush to the mountain tops. So it was a beautiful scene. And now that we were leaving Rabu, Rabu is the name of the place. So when they were about to, the journey is still going on. When the chapter started, journey is on to Mount Kailash. They are moving. They stayed at a place named Rabu for a short span. And after that, Lamo or Hamo, also you can say Hamo, said she wanted to give me a farewell present. So that girl, because he stayed over there for a few days, so this girl became friends with him. She gave him a farewell present. And one evening I had told her through Daniel that, through Daniel, see, because this girl also, a local girl of Tibet, she does not know language of narrator, Nick Middleton's language. So he has hired a translator named Daniel. So Daniel ke through hi wo baat karta hai, jisse bhi karni hoti hai wahan pe. Through Daniel, one evening he told her that I was heading towards Mount Kailash to complete the Kora, that religious journey. And she had said that I ought to get some warmer clothes. And that girl told him that you do not have that warm clothes, you need it. So after ducking back, after going in and coming back within a short span, she emerged carrying one of the long sleeved sheepskin coats that all the men wore. Wahan pe, if you go to such places, na, there are a particular dress and attire, people definitely wear it, you know. Long gum boots and big sheepskin coats, and sometimes they carry hot water, or you can say wo koile hote hai na, coal ko thoda sa garam karke they keep it near the heart to make it warm so that they can have heart attacks easily in such weather. So at different, you know, such places have difficulties to survive also. So hum itni thand mein dar jate hain, these people survive in such minus degree temperatures. So she gifts him long sleeve sheepskin coats that all men wore. Satan sized me up as we clambered into his car. Oh yes, he declared, Drukba sir. Satan, fine, I told you already who is Satan. A local Tibetan who would, guide the visitors. So a tourist guide them up. And after getting the gift from a girl, then Satan was there to help him, tourist guide. He clambered into his car. They went into their cars and, oh yes, he declared Drukba sir. What is Drukba, beta? This word, please underline the meaning of this, underline this word. Meaning is people in, people in that rocky wilderness with the flock and all. Jaise aap dekhte ho ki bahut sare log hote hain, they keep on taking their animals out. Fine, flock, group of animals. Group ko kehte the flock, fine. So when they carry their animals all together in a group outside and wearing a particular dress, so he declared Drukba sir. Then means raaste mein unko aise scenes, they are very common, like sheep leke ja rahe hote hain, Drukba sir. We took a shortcut to get off the Shangtang. Satan knew a route that would take us southwest, almost directly towards Mount Kailash. So unhone shortcut liya to get off the Shangtang, that place. Satan ko ek shortcut pata tha because he was already a local man over there, a tourist guide, so they know better than us. And do you think, is it a good idea, anybody can tell me, is it a good idea to hire a tourist guide, or it is just sheer wastage of money according to you? Yes, Raghav, do you think we should hire a tourist guide?
Yes, ma'am, because we do not know about the place.
Yes, we do not know about
that mountain place. It may also be risky.
Yes, very good. So it can be risky for our lives. You can mute yourself, brother. So it can be risky for our lives as well as it will save our time also. They know better the place, you know. They can teach us, they can tell us where to go, which route to take, and all. But we have to choose our guide very carefully. And specifically, if it is approved by the government, if they have license, not any local, you know, you never know how they are going to help you. So there are authorized ones also that you should take while going to such journeys. Okay. We took a shortcut to get off the Shangtang. Satan knew a route that would take us southwest, almost directly towards Mount Kailash. So he says, ki, mujhe pata hai rasta, I will take you towards southwest and directly Mount Kailash places there. It involved crossing several fairly high mountain passes. Passes aate hai na, raaste mein points aate hai, bahut sare. Multiple high mountain passes, he said. But no problem, sir. He assured us, if there is no snow, What was the likelihood of that? I asked, not knowing, sir, until we get there. So he says that I don't know whether we will be having difficulty, but jab tak pahunchenge nahi, we will not, I cannot decide and I cannot tell you what will be there. Excuse me. From the gently rolling hills of Rabu. So they were at a place, safer area. Rabu ki jo hills thi, they were very quiet, you can say gentle, which they can handle, even a simple driver can handle it. Fine. And but how they're going to move to the place, then mostly you can say difficulty will be there for them. Shortcut took us across vast open plains with nothing in them except a few gazelles. Fine. Small, it is, what is a gazelle? It is a beta, you can say a small slender antelope that has curved horns and a fawn colored coat with white underparts, and it is basically found in various countries. Fine. So this creature is found there. So gazelles are there to be found, except a few gazelles. They found it and then they moved further. Sketch of Mount Kailash. You can see in front of you. So this is the sketch of Mount Kailash. To reach there is really difficult. You know, people who are of religious bent of mind and strong determination and healthy, only they are able to reach at such places. That would look up for nibbing the red pastures and frown before bounding away into void. Further on, where the plains became more stony than grassy, a great herd of wild ass came into view. Satan told us we were approaching them long before they appeared. Kyank, he said, pointing towards a far off pile of dust. When we drew near, I could see the herd galloping en masse, wheeling and turning in tight formation as if they were practicing maneuvers on some predetermined course. Plumes of dust billowed into the crisp, clean air. Now you refer back to the meanings already written, maneuvers, military exercises, billowed, filled with air. Fine. So there are some words like kyang is the word, no? Let me tell you for this. Kyang is the wild ass of Tibet, fine? So it is over 4 feet high at the shoulder of a dark reddish color with a narrow strip along the back. So ye jo, you know, sub animals are found at such places, fine? So they have mentioned it. So wild ass of Tibet, you can say 4 feet high, clear? So, then during the way when they were moving, they saw a good herd, a great herd of wild ass. So I told you that was a common scene. Jo drokbaz hote the wahan ke local people with the herds of different animal like sheep and dogs. Sometime there are mastiffs, you know, different dogs are found there. Wild ass. So kyang, jisko keh dete unki language, local language mein Tibet ki. So they saw that also over there, and dusts over there, and clean air is, you can say, billowed into the crisp, like filled with air and swelled out, billowed me. But air is quite clean at such places because, you know, man's reach, jahan pe nahi hai, wahan pe to obviously God's grace will always be there. So these places are, that's why they are beautiful, because trees are not being cut. Air is as clear, fine, that you can breathe it properly. As hills started to push up once more from the rocky wilderness, we passed solitary drokbas tending their flock. So next day passed through solitary, means all alone. Drokbas, I told you, local people taking the herds or flocks at one to another place. Sometimes they can be men, sometimes they can be women also. These well-wrapped figures would pause and stare at our car, occasionally waving as we passed. So this is the daily routine of such people, to look at the travelers and visitors, and sometimes they wave at them. When the track took us close to their animals, the sheep would take evasive action, veering away from the speeding vehicle. And animals also start running away by seeing the vehicle. They get scared. We passed nomads, dark tents pitched in splendid isolation. Nomads, you know, there are some people without any identity, they are living in tents. So at such places, you can see such seas, otherwise not visible. Nomad, you know, nomad, it's a kind of community. Right? Community of people who have, you know, they have fixed habitation at one place. What tents laga ke in jagah pe reh rahe, how they are managing the things together. So we will start from nomads tomorrow. Bell ho chuki hai. As I have already, I appreciate you all for registering yourself on Diksha portal. I guess almost everybody has done, and I saw that your messages you sent. And if any requirement is there, you have to respond accordingly quickly, okay? So please let me know. 4 or 5 students have sent the certificate of vaccination already. But if anyone else is there who has received the shot but has not sent the certificate, needful right now. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day.